Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are. I hope you are staying safe and well during these difficult times. I would like to start thanking the Global Tuna Alliance and Pew for organizing this workshop and inviting me to be here. I'm very happy to be here. Tuna is in my heart for a lot of reasons, but let me start from the very first beginning. So perhaps you never worried about it and you never heard, but tuna is a word of Greek origin. And I'm Greek, you know. So tuna, the word, is coming from the ancient Greek word thino, which was translated in Latin as tuno. And thino is a verb, it means rush. And it was used for warriors going to the battle. So we are talking about warriors of the sea, and we have to respect them. I'm very happy about this workshop because it is focused on European Union. European Union can play a very, very important role, referring to the global tuna game. European Union is the biggest, the greatest consumer of tuna products around the world, let alone the big role EU plays, referring to fishing interests, trade agreements, and also international cooperation. Also, I would like to add that I'm very happy about this workshop because it's going to focus, as I understood, to markets, to the industry, to the private sector. So this focus on all these issues is very, very important for me. Though I have been a politician in my previous life, and though I served as a European Commissioner for Marine for 5 years, taking some very important decisions, in my opinion, at last for tuna, I have to say from the beginning that I have realized that this would not be possible without the stakeholders. And let me give you just 3 cases as examples. When I took office back a decade ago, the first decision that came onto my desk was the decision about fishing bluefin tuna in the Mediterranean Sea. It was a difficult decision. We have taken scientific advice that the stock was at peril at that time. And though we had a very, very good consultation with all stakeholders, it was obvious that a small part of the industry focused on short terms will not like a decision that can limit down fishing possibilities. I took the right decision. Though it was my first decision, I dared to do it. But then I had a really hard time. And I had a hard time because some member states were very noisy, very loudly speaking, and also this part of the industry was very negative about that decision. But then, and this is my experience, some people came to save me. And I was saved by alliance, by an alliance that was created by stakeholders, big retailers, big supply chains. I'm very happy to see some of them participating in Global Tuna Alliance today, by Pew and other NGOs who have created another alliance, but also I was saved by concerned citizens, celebrities, artists, chefs, everywhere, everybody was there. So this was a success story. Another success story I would like to share with you was my first attempt to go for the trade regulation, the control regulation that EU has for fisheries. And this regulation is very, very hard to be implemented because it foresees trade measures. To make a long story short, European Union can stop the imports from countries that are not cooperative, referring to the fishing rules, data, sharing information, whatever. When I started implementing the regulation, in the beginning, there were a couple of countries small, but then on my office was a big decision about a big country, Asian country, with a great influence on tuna and also other industries. And a lot of my fellow commissioners were concerned about the consequences that our relations with this country might have in our foreign policy, international cooperation, et cetera. So there, and I would like to say this because you have to know that you are very powerful, then the markets saved my dilemma, saved the problem, because they came in suggesting that we have to go for it. This was the only way to persuade the government of this country to go with the rules. The third example I would like to share with you was my effort to create a new generation of fisheries agreements by European Union. You know, we sign agreements as Europeans to have our fleets fishing in other areas around the world. And these agreements are not always the best. So I have tried a lot to change this situation. I have done something, but I would like to say that a lot much has been done after I left the Commission by my successors. So now I think we are almost there, but we have to do more to be sure that these fisheries agreements are decoupled from other interests and can focus on the stock situation and the survival of the fishing and industry sector. And you can be heard there. If you have an opinion, please express it. Through the stakeholders' consultation, the legislators have to hear to you, as I have done, as European Commission always does. So this was 10 years ago. Can you imagine what is the progress right now? Because at that time, sustainability was not so much in fashion. Now European Union has these big green deals, green orientations. And they are trying to have the best from science. They are trying to have the best from innovation and technology. And I'm very happy you are going to focus on the new ideas that are there, like electronic monitoring on vessels or satellite images from satellites above the sky. So you can make the difference. A last few words on RFMOs, or Regional Fisheries Management Organizations. I know that a lot of you, and I can say me myself, we are not always happy with the performance of these RFMOs. But this is the only governance international platform we have. So we have to try, and you have to be there because you can take the best of the decisions. I can give you the example. Now I'm sitting on the board of Maritime Stewardship Council, the MSC, which is a big certification organization known worldwide. And we are doing our best for our engagement and strategy on RFMOs. We are doing that with partners like Pew and others. So this is the way to go forward. To make a long story short, if you ask me what is the message I would like to convey, it is simple. I can say one phrase. Politicians cannot do it alone. You have to jump in, you have to be heard. This is absolutely important because for this century and especially for this decade, leadership cannot be there without partnership. Actually, partnership is the new leadership. And even if all the politicians don't know it yet, they will know. Just be sure and do the good job. Thank you for listening.